I do love the change in the music though when you give her the eyes. Did I read? I read the Dragon Slayer's Soul, and I believe putting on that by Silk Spot and Hunt, and I believe I went over the armor and stuff as well. Because I wouldn't be back in Firelink Shrine if I didn't. What? Yeah, okay, yeah, that'd be it. Undead Bone Shard. Let's burn that. There we go. Now there's one more Bone Shard and one more Estus Flask in the game. I remember what the Bone Shard is. The Estus Flask... I remember that is. Okay. Yeah, I remember. Alright, let's go. Alright, not sure how long I'm gonna, like, I could finish the game in this sitting, probably won't, not sure how far I'll get, we'll see. And I find this area weird, because there's nothing here, like, this looks like there could be stuff here, but there's not, there's just stuff. Also, I want to assume this is the king and queen, but I doubt it, because one, the tits aren't big enough for that to be Guinevere, and that. I mean, that could be the king, who knows. But, like, there's all of this, and it looks like there could be something. But there isn't. It's just exists. For some reason. Yeah, no treasure ahead, no hint ahead. It's just, there's nothing. There's nothing. Oh. Well, there's an item, but I mean, like, of importance. I mean, there's nothing of importance. There's a shard, but you wouldn't make this whole area for a shard, would you? Well, saying that, it's FromSoft. They probably would. But it's like, feels like there should be more. Ah, well. Got another bonfire, because that was an arduous journey we just took. I can see the bonfire from here. Alright. And here's an old friend of ours. Grand Archives Key and Goddard Twin Swords. You remember Goddard, right? You guys remember Goddard? Black Sword Goddard helped us with the Pontiff and the Abyss Watchers. Did I summon him for the Abyss Watchers? I'm not sure. But I know I summoned him for the Pontiff. Yeah, where is your Twin Swords, bruh? Bruh, where is your Twin Swords? The hunters known as the King's Black Hands wielded a pair of weapons. These belonged to Goddard, who fled the castle. Goddard rose quickly through knighthood, no surprise to those who have witnessed his swordsmanship. Yeah. But you dead now, Goddard? You dead, bruh, you fled the castle. Why? Cause shit's fucked up in there. Key to the main entrance of the Grand Archives of Lothric. With the fire fading and the spreading pus of man tainting the castle, the Grand Archives were closed his doors for good. Today only a few of this key remain. This one likely belongs to Goddard, one of the King's Black Hands who fled the castle. The spreading pus of man tainting the castle. I don't. Like, at first I think, okay, it's the black symbiote sludge stuff, but there's none of that in the castle. Like, the two dragons is the last you see of it. So, I don't know. Anyway, we about to meet an old friend. We about to meet an old friend up in here. Hey, buddy! Hey, Crystal Buddy, what's up? I killed your brother! I killed your brother, you know? I've got his soul in my inventory. What you gonna do? What you gonna do, Crystal Boy? Yeah, there's the other crystal sage right in here. Is there no item down there? There's a load of these guys in here, and that's annoying as all hell. Trust me, it gets irritating the amount of people, or the amount of these little scampy cunts that are in here. But at least there's now chunks for days. Not going to help me with this weapon, but if I ever switch out, like, I might end up going for the greatsword, we'll see. I might switch out for the greatsword when I go to the optional area. I am uncertain. I'm undecided. There we go. I really dislike when sound cuts out of my headphones because it feels so weird to play in utter silence because you can't hear sound cues, you can't hear enemies. It's a weird experience, but sound will pop back eventually. I hope. Alright, chunk. Thank you. See, now I would have heard that. I'ma just do things slightly easier. Also, the ones that have the candles lit on their head, they are stronger. God damn, did I pull a... I didn't pull the second one, that's alright. I really don't need to do... I can just run up and just kill them, but... It's very rare that I have a bow and arrow in a Souls game. It's very rare that I utilize ranged combat, so I figured I may as well. I'll make the most of it, why not? Okay, I'll kill the last one. What you got? What you got? What you got, Candle Girl? You got nothing. You're dead now. You're dead now, Candle People. Now, I believe this way is a dead end. Oh, no, this is just... Nope, this way. You all right, buddy? You guarding the dead end? Yeah, you got an item on a dead end, I believe. Yeah. Ah, the crystal chime. And Loth... Oh, yeah, that Lothric gear. I need that now, don't I? Well, that was going to be my... Until the end game stuff. But now I've got Black Iron stuff, so it's unneeded. Sacred Trine, once in possession of Gertrude, the Heavenly Daughter, and defiled by the scholars of the Grand Archives. The power of crystals granted the scholars a degree of success. In this case, their work enabled this chime to be suitable for casting both miracles and sorceries. And I'm just going to see if I can get sound back in my headphones. Okay, there we go. Yeah. So Gertrude, Heavenly Daughter, locked away in the Grand Archives, and her chime was defiled by the scholars of the Grand Archives with crystals. Because, like Osiris, well, I'm pretty sure Osiris had the scholars look into crystals and Seath and all that shit. And so, they... The best I can think of it, that the reasoning behind it was Gertrude being the Heavenly Daughter, who is also a is it mentioned in Worship of Divine Messengers is viewed as heresy in Lothric and unrecognized by any of the Three Pillars. This is believed to be why Gertrude the Heavenly Daughter was imprisoned in a lofty cell of the Grand Archives. So Since the king and queen's daughter was a heretic, basically, they decided that she, being of royal blood of the old gods, and a heretic, was the best, what would you call it? I guess subject, would be the best subject for their experiments. Taking her divine power and her chime, which is of the gods, and using it for their shit. It's hard to say, really, but, like, that's the best I can come up with. Like, the king decided... Also, the reason why you want to put wax on your head is because these things curse you like mad. So these, so you can just walk through with the candle wax on your head. No one gives a damn. You can't get cursed. It's all good. But yeah, so I believe the king decided that because his daughter was a heretic, that... Did I take off the... God, did I... Since his daughter was a heretic, he wouldn't really care if she was used for experiments and whatnot. Where is... Oh, there you are. Okay. As to what Guinevere thought about that, I can't say, because she seems like the type of girl that would still protect her daughter regardless, but I don't know. Power within? I don't think you ever find out what happens to the queen. Because Osiris turned into a dragon and went mad. You meet the two princes, you find out what happened with Gertrude, you meet Gertrude, but I don't think you ever find out what happened to Guinevere. She just sort of fucks off. Power within, there we go, old favourite. Forbidden pyromancy among those who internalize flame, temporarily boost attack, but gradually lose HP. A pyromancer fears the flame, however, this fear subsides once it is accepted as a substitute for strength. And in here, we have the witch's locks, which is a whip, I believe. Yeah. A whip fashioned from the black hair of the daughter of the Witch of Izalith, creator of the Chaos Flame, or Flame of Chaos. Long shining locks woven together to create this whip are imbued with the essence of fire, which can be channeled through the use of its skill. Who the fuck found... Like, there were three surviving, to our knowledge, and actually there were four. To our knowledge, there were four surviving daughters of the Witch of Chaos. There was Quelana, who teaches you fire pyromancy, who teaches you pyromancy and all that shit. We found her dead. There was the Fair Lady, we found her dead. Quelag, you kill her yourself. And the fourth one, who we don't know, who was guarding the entrance to the Bed of Chaos. So whether it was one of them, or another sister, that they took this hair from, we don't know. And I don't think we ever will know, but it's like, damn. Like, that takes dedication right there. Ask her about it. I don't know. Which would be crazy. Also, the wax is worn off. That's never a good sign. Never a good sign to have wax wear off. Can you jump in here? Nope. Alright. Dunk that shit, bruh. Ignore the fact that I was wearing a helmet and now I'm not. Ignore that. Because that's not important. Why would you pay attention to stuff like that? That's just crazy talk. Hello. Goodbye. High night scale, I'll take that. Hey miss, what's up? Yeah, that's it. You cover me in wax, that's what you like. That's your fetish. No, but if they cover you in too much wax, you can't roll or anything. It gets rather irritating. And that chunk thing. They're just throwing upgrade. Like, the pacing for upgrades in this game is just, I want to say, just ridiculous. Like, you get no chunks until after an Orlando. At that point, you should have more than just a simple plus six weapon. Also, doing this lowers a bookcase so you can get an item. I thought there was a guy up there. Soon. That item is somewhat important, but the one behind it, that's more important. Now, do I go up here and attack? Nah. Let's go here first. We've got some stuff to collect, yo. We've got a few things we want to collect. Take you out, because you're a bitch. Take you out, because you're a bitch. No. No. I said no. Now for the fun parts. Oh, wait, no, I didn't open the shortcut. That would be helpful. Kick that shit down. Now do what I was meant to do. Can you not? Can you not, Crystal Boy? A little busy. Doing stuff. Alright, so we draw up here. I'ma just heal up. And roll! Yeah! I swear to God, if you knock me off. Okay, good. I swear to God, Crystal Mage. Not in the mood for your bullshit right now. And we have the Avalyn. Ah, yeah. Never gonna use it, but ah, yeah. Extremely rare rapid firing crossbow. Fires three successive bolts by means of an elaborate mechanism. Inflict heavy damage by making all three shots count. Despite its use as a weapon, this crossbow is also a priceless work of art and bears resemblance to a musical instrument. I mean, it kind of looks like a violin. If that's what they're getting at, it kind of looks like a violin. A bit. I'm not surprised there's nothing else up here, but yeah. Alright, well, we just roll back down. And now to get through that bookcase that we opened up. I believe it's just a Titanite scale, I think. I don't remember what's in here. Oh, Titanite slab. Okay, well, that is actually worth your time. Alright, then you win this round game. You don't need the torch to get through this area. But I do. I like it. I like having light. And is there... Oh yeah, okay. How about you go fuck yourself? How about you two go fuck? Okay. All right, let's have some fun. God damn it. Just go with game. Titanite chunk. You could go up there and behind. Actually, let's do that. Fuck it. You run away. You die. Which is irritating. Any drops? No drops. I don't know if these guys can drop their gear. I've only ever seen them drop their weapon. Okay. You know what, Crystal Sage? How about fuck you? I did 12 damage. Alright. Thrall Hood, thank you for that. Really? I really hate these enemies, and thankfully, I believe this is the last I'll ever see of them. That one is the last one, I think. Could be wrong. Probably am. Right now, we could go and kill the crystal bitch, but... Hey, buddy! How's it going? How's it going? Are you the third? Are you the third and last Aerophil Knight? I believe you are. You're the last one in the game. And the other two have dropped nice weapons. You must drop something pretty cool yourself, I bet. And I bet whatever you dropped totally isn't just a straight up Berserk reference. And I'm gonna just heal up. There we go. Goodbye, buddy. And he outride the night set. Armor of the Aerophil outride the night, enveloped in a dimly cool air. The knights were given the eyes of the Pontiffs, but the eyes transformed them into savage, raven warriors who only knew how to serve as mindless guards. I still need to sell all that. Dimly called air, serve as mindless guards. Mindless guards. Mindless guards, okay. So yeah, the Outrider Knights are basically a reference to Guts in Berserk when he gets the Berserk armor. Soulstream, and yep, no illusion ahead. But yeah, so Pontiff Sullivan made people go insane and just be his personal bitches. Now, Soulstream, where would that be? There we are. Soulstream. Oh, right, okay, well. Sorcery implied by the first of the scholars when Lothric and the Grand Archives were but young, fires a torrential volley of souls. The first of the scholars doubted the linking of the fire and was alleged to be a private mentor to the royal prince. Yeah, son. That explains why the prince is like, nah, man, linking the fire is kind of bullshit. Kind of bullshit, don't want to do that, man. Don't want to do that, man. It's kind of bullshit. It's like, nah, you gotta. I'll deal with you in a second. Drivenstein, thank you. Now, down here, is a Red Eye Knight. There's no point going down there. Because he, like, apart from, like, you know, the usual drops that the Lothric Knights can drop, he drops nothing. He drops nothing important, and there's nothing else down there. Don't know why you can go there. And the Crystal Skull. Secret Crystal Skull of the Grand Archives of Lothric, gift to a sorcerer to learn crystal sorceries. These sorceries are the work of the Pale Drake, Sif Descalus, whom Logan is said to have met. A branch sorcery that has been carried on by the Crystal Sages. And that's it. Anything? Well, it's you, but do I have a reason to want to? I'll be back. There we go. So now if I go back up. Send you back down. There we go. Now we're gonna kill this mofo. Yeah! And we drop down here. There's that ladder I kicked down. And the opening. The shortcut I just lowered. Fun times for everybody. I'm only like halfway through the area. Will I make this one episode? Probably will. Don't see why not. Send you back down. Yeah, I don't see why I wouldn't really. Like that was maybe half hour. The rest of this will probably be 20 minutes. So that's about an episode. About an average episode for me. Oh, there's an item I missed. Well, we can't have that. We can't have me missing items. Nope. Nope. Ain't having that. Especially if I don't remember what it is. Okay, I doubt it's something special, but I can see it. I can see it. Therefore, I have to have it. Like, I don't think I've missed an item so far. Maybe, I don't know. Oh, time to scale. That's actually somewhat helpful. Like, unless like, there's invisible walls that I've missed, I don't think I have missed a single item. No, I don't want to say that. I don't want to say that, but I mean, it's possible. It's possible. What the fuck am I doing? I have one Estus left. The fuck am I doing? Do you know what's ahead? I'm gonna need more than one Estus before I get to the next bonfire. What the hell am I doing? Man, I'm crazy. I'm crazy, man. What's going on here? Huh. I don't remember all these signs. I don't remember all these summon signs when I was here last. Why do you have the symbol of avarice on your head? What are you farming here? Not you. Where did they go? Wait, what are you farming? There's nothing to farm here. Is there? I don't think so. Ah, okay. Maybe he just likes how it looks. Who knows? Who knows? Hey, almost got caught there. Hey, almost got caught. Not gonna happen. So let's just whoop your ass. Nope. No wax for me. A lot of curse though. That's a lot of curse though. Nope. Ain't nobody got time for your curses. Nobody got time for that. Nobody. Ain't nobody got time for that, man. Come on. Come on, dog. Yeah, you get to live. You get to live. Always get behind that guy, otherwise he'll run down there, and that's not a fun time. Because they're everywhere. This ring. This is a fun ring. Oh. This. Yeah, this is a good spot. Alright. Yeah. Raises poison, bleed, curse, and frost. So it's basically all these into one. All of these into one. Can I, like curse ring, that's poison, blood, dark, magic, curse, there we go. Alright, so, it's not as good as an individual one, but, no, it doesn't do dark. Set 4, 7, 4, not as good as an individual one, but, it doesn't. It does them good. Good to cover your bases, yo. Look at these fuckers. What do they do? What do you do? Like, that one description, that one mention of the Pilgrim Butterfly is all you get from these things. What are they? What do they do? There's nothing. Nothing to my knowledge that I've found. Unless there's like new shit and new items and new game plus I don't know about. It's like, tell me. What is thine purpose? Is that? Yeah, that's what that knight is that said that the area is useless. Because it is. There's nothing for you there. Where are you? Oh. My bad, G. My bad, I thought you were on the other side. How'd you like that? How'd you like that? My shield blocks just as well as your just as well as your stone wings, bitch. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna do that. Chunk. Seriously, like the upgrade pacing in this game is so weird. It's like, you get end game, it's like, okay, here's chunks. You're now allowed plus. You're now allowed past plus six. It's like, oh, thank you, game. Thank you for allowing me this privilege now. Come on. See now, if you would drop your weapon, that would be cool. You want to drop your weapon for me? You going to be a cool bruh? He's not a cool bruh. Alright. Now, where is it? That was very risky boots. That was very risky boots right there. That could have ended poorly. Okay. Alright, well. That one fell off the edge. That works. You see now, you know what'd be cool? If you guys didn't flurry with every fucking movement. Just a suggestion. And this is the one that fell off, the one that had the scythe. Because I kind of still want to read the item description about the scythe, because it mentions Priscilla. Which then brings in the question, why the fuck do these people know about Priscilla? Why would you hide this from me, game? God damn it. Hey, buddy. Take that. Use a bitch. Nah. What are you gonna do about that, boy? I had visions of him just jumping up and somehow hitting me still. It's like, oh, you wanna talk shit, do you? You wanna talk shit? Well, you gonna get hit. But he can't hit this. He can't hit none of this, boy. You know what I'm about? I'm about the Iron Tarkus life. Kind of weird how you can get here, but there's nothing. Unless you can... I'm not going to, but... maybe you can survive that. I don't think you can. Cause, like, I feel like I've done it before. And my memory just escapes me. Now, where... Oh, here it is. Alright. Yeah! Alright, we got this item. Planet Scales, thank you very much. Anything here? Nope. And we have... we have a scampi cunt. But this is a special scampi cunt. Looking familiar? You should. Grey rat's ashes. Umbral ash of grey rat of the undead settlement. With this, the shrine maiden will prepare new items. Grey rat was a poor thief who fancied himself a martyr for the poor, which is what drove him to climb the wall. And now Grey Rat is dead. Rest in peace, Grey Rat. Rest in pepperonis, as they say in the dank maymays. Oh, I have to make it through again, don't I? God damn it. Well, alright. That's not too bad. It's not too bad, I guess. But yeah, so Grey Rat dead. Grey Rat would die at Irithyll if Sigvard or Patches wasn't there to save him. I've still never got Patches to do it, which is like you're meant to send off Grey Rat, and then Patches is meant to say like, yeah, where's Grey Rat gone? And then you turn back Irithyll, he's like, ah, nah, hell nah, man. You're also meant to be able to tell Patches about sending him to the High Wall. And Patches meant to go, oh, hell nah, man, hell nah. But I didn't. I haven't checked this time. Maybe if I talk to Patches now before giving his ashes to the Shrine Maiden, maybe he'll mention it, but I never got him to bring it up before. But yeah, so that's the end of Grey Rat's chain. So we finished Grey Rat, we finished Sigvard, we've finished Patches technically. We've got Aegon's, which is almost. Goddamn. Alright, you then. Fine, I'll just fight the gargoyle. Fuck y'all. But yeah, we've got Irina's questline we've done. She's now a firekeeper. There's two ends to that questline. There's fight all the dark miracles and have Aegon take her from you, which then results in, you know, you having to kill Aegon and Irina asking you to kill her because she's fallen to the dark. Can you just die? There we go. So now we just have one final step. There we go. One final step of Aegon's questline, which we can do now, actually. It happens once you beat the Dragon Slayer armor. So we can do it now. Where? Oh, okay. Stone torch hammer wielded by gargoyles of the profane capital, the profane flame, which never goes out, imbues this weapon with a fire attack. Thank you. Thank you for all that lore. Alright, so we go up here. Drop down here. Is that another gargoyle? Yeah, there is. Alright. Why? There's two. You know what? Fuck it. Why there are two gargoyles of the profane capital at the Grand Archives of Lothric Castle? I do not know. Any items? Nope. Okay, you two have fun. I have no reasonable speculation as to why profane capital gargoyles are at the Grand Archives outside Lothric Castle. Anyway, you see this guy right here? Undead Bone Shard, ah yeah. That's the last one. The last Bone Shard. And we open up this shortcut. Never have to go out there again. Is this really needed? I mean, if you want to do a mad dash, I guess. Yeah, how about you go to hell? How about you go to hell? As for your friend as well. I said, how about your friend as well? How about your friend as well? How about your friend as well? There we go. Alright. Alright, we can play games. We can play all of the games if that's what you want. I still never bought fire bombs, but I don't really need to at this point. Hey, buddy. Overlooking everything? How's it going? You got a good view from up here? Yeah, you do. You saw me kill the Crystal Sage, didn't you? Couldn't have been happy about that. Oh yeah, lightning. Because you guys used to fight dragons and shit as well. Well, drakes, really. But then we're pushing semantics. Pushing semantics. Dynamite chunk, thank you. Nice hit. Oh yeah, because you can come. Alright, yeah, alright. Yeah, because that's where I fought one of the gargoyles. Alright. You can also drop from up there, which, as you can see from that item, we are going to get. They're going to get up there eventually. Fairly important stuff up there. How important to this build? Not very, but... Right, let's just pull you. Do you remember this guy? You remember way back to like part 2? I summoned a guy to help me fight Vought. Albert, I believe his name was. Well, this is him. This is good old Albert. And we're fighting all three at once now. Yay. Come on, Albert. Bye-bye, Albert. I will indeed take your gold wing crest shield, which I will read after this. Also, killing him is what gets you the Farum armor set. Come on. Come on, Black Hand Man. Black Hand Man, come on. Twin Katana, brother. There we go. It's fun fighting fast weapon users when there's no poison in the game. God damn it. And that's your last Estus. Yeah, you do that. You do that, buddy. I'm gonna just sit over here. Oh yeah, bow and arrow. That's what you want. That's what you want when you're in sword combat. That's what you want when you're in sword combat. Bow and arrow. Well done. Fucking, okay. This lady, what she loves to do is parry. This bitch loves to parry people. And she didn't. Oh, you didn't get to. You didn't get to, girl. Square up. Alright. So I got the gold wing crest shield. Blue knight shield engraved with golden wind crest. This shield is exceptional amongst the enchanted blue shields. So it's D's. But better. But not only does it boost high magic absorption, but also enables the ward of the parry spells. I have never found a use for that because I'm not good at parrying. But I can imagine it being really good. And Onikiri and Ubadachi. Hunters known as the King's Black Hands wielded paired weapons. This belonged to Kamui, who looked after the prince. Kamui brought Onikiri with him to the undead settlement, where he forged Ubadachi and was finally prepared to join the ranks of the Royal Hunters. And he has Oni Slayer, which is that jump attack move. And crystal calyx presented as a gift by the crystal sages to their favorite pupil, Kriemhild. This is the girl that invaded us when we went to the unattended graves. This is that crystal girl that fell off the edge. So she's their favorite pupil because she's shit, I guess. Crystal spheres devour the will of the user, and this staff increases the potency of sorceries at the cost of increased FP consumption for skills. Yeah, son. So we took out a person who looked after the prince, a knight, and the twin sage's favourite pupil. Because fuck y'all noise. Now there's all these summon signs here for a reason. Because we're coming up to a place. We're coming up near to a place, yo.
But before we do that, we gotta go back to Firelink.
Before we finish up this area, we're gonna go back to Firelink. And also, one extra place that we gotta go to.
One extra place.
We could do it later, but I wanna do it now before fighting the final boss. Well, not the final boss, before fighting the final Lord of Cinder. I love this music. Ominous as... Actually, let me see if Patches has anything to say. I mean, this music is ominous as all fuck, but I love this music. Well, it's not so much ominous as it is somber.
Hey, what happened to Grey Rat anyhow? I haven't seen him at all lately. Well, if you know where he scurried off to, be sure and tell me. Now, I need to stock up. And if he's gone and croaked, he'll have left a gold mine. Off to Lothric, the castle of no return. That old thief's lost it if he thinks he has a chance in there. But it's not like he's new to this game. What's got into him? That old thief. He's really lost it this time.
Okay, is that all you have to say? You have anything more? Alright. Look, Ringfinger, I know you've been sitting here waiting for me to do your quest line, but I can't, okay? If I do your quest line, Sirius will hate me, and I can't make Bay hate me. I'm sorry. We have to wait until I'm done with Bay's quest line. Don't worry about it, girl. You're top bae. Don't worry about it. Sirius is bae, but you're top bae. She's second bae. It's all good. Actually, no, because there's also Arena. There's also Yuria. There's also Carla. This game has too many bae's! But listen to Firekeeper, you up there, okay? You are tied first with Carla for top bae. Just... Okay? Do you wanna... No, that's a bow. That's not what I wanted. Okay, listen, just be cute for me. Now, why did I bow? That'll give me a bow. Okay, will you have to praise the sun? That's a bow. That's a bow. There we go, there's the cute giggle. And you have one more. No. She has two that are cute. There's the bow, there's the giggle, and there's one other. No, don't giggle at me, girl. Yes, you're giggling because I'm beckoning you to my bedroom, but it's not what I'm after. Please, just do the cute thing. Oh my god. Okay, I can't tell if that's you either being scared or being embarrassed or what, but that's not what I'm after. Oh my god. If I toast you, will you do it? There we go! The cute little twirl. That's all I wanted, girl. That's all I wanted, the cute little twirl. Thank you. Jesus.
Ah, well.
Actually, I won't give you Grey Rat stuff yet, just in case. No, I don't have the other shard. I'm close to it, though.
Back again, I see. Perfect timing, too.
Oh, you're gonna be diverted, boy. Don't worry.
Unfathomable. This is a crystal sorcery. Created by the Pale Dragon. Thought only to exist in legend. I am ever grateful to you. This is truly sublime. I am afraid this is a debt I cannot repay. Only, I will be sure to unravel it for you. Just a moment.
And now we got the last few sorceries. There's a lot more sorceries than miracles in this game. Homing Crystal Soul Mass sharpens Homing Soul Mass via crystallization. Releases a Homing Crystal Soul Mass. Crystal Soul Mass has piercing qualities. According to the Crystal Sages, Big Hat Logan, or Old Big Hat Logan, achieved enlightenment within the Regal Archives, where he came to find the quintessence of sorcery in the facets of a certain crystal. That's the crystal that Sieve had for immortality. Crystal Soul Spear further sharpens Soul Spear by crystallization. According to the Crystal Sages, same thing. And further sharpens weapon via crystallization. After much experimentation, Logan found crystal medium facilitated a stronger bond between weapon and soul. That's all of his stuff.
In Vinheim, I was an assassin. A sorcerer only in name. A killer for hire. What a fool I was, thinking one day I would learn real sorceries. When I became undead, I was exiled from the school. But here I am, now, exploring the depths of sorcery. All thanks to you, I might add. You are no ordinary man. All these sorceries, and you've mastered every one. If this were the Dragon School, you'd be, well, overtly despised and banished from the place. Well, I suppose it's time I pack my bags. I would hate to see our agreement end sourly. Better left, tucked away, as a pleasant memory. You are no ordinary. I would hate to. Better left. I promise to stay safe. It's been nice running our own little school.
It has, sir, hasn't it? It has. And you're still basically useless.
Ah, there I am, please.
Yeah, you can. No. Oh, I can't even have the option. Okay. Well, since we picked up the Dark Tomes from Arena when she became a Firekeeper, we can now give them to Carla.
Ah, hello again. Thank goodness. Yes. Yes. You require my sorceries, I presume? Oh, is this a divine tome? What on earth are you thinking? I wouldn't go near a divine tome, or any so-called miracle. And casters of miracles are sure to steer clear of me. So please, don't torture me so.
Yeah, she's not a fan of divine tomes.
There is one thing that there is a dark... whether the...
But if you just ask her a second time...
Ah, oh, you. How could you? Oh. I know. I owe my life to you. Fine then. But just this once, I will tell you this tale. But do understand, it will be my first time. I'll have no sniggering, should I err.
She's great.
Ah, oh, You. How could you? Oh. I know. I know. I owe my life to you. Fine, then. But just this once, I will tell you this tale. I'll have no sniggering should I err.
And now we can buy all of the dark miracles that Arena would have taught us. So we may as well just do that, because money is literally no object.
There is one thing.
I don't think like buying all of her stuff does anything with Carla. Like, her quest basically begins and ends at finding her. And that's really about it. And that's everyone. What else has Cirrus got? Oh no, okay. Cirrus and Obrick, the Vinheim guy, they have one more step to their quest line, and it's at the same place. So I'm gonna do that. But first, where would be the quickest? Cliff Underside. Yeah, so Vinheim Boy and Cirrus have one more step to their quest lines. This is the last step to, technically it's the last step to Aegon's quest line. If you call collecting the reward the last step. Arena's has been done. Carla's is basically non-existent. Same with Cornex. Basically non-existent with him as well. Grey Rats is done because he's dead as fuck. Sigwurtz is done. People are dying. So, we're basically wrapping up endgame now. Like, once we finish Ciri's and Orbred's questline, the only people with questlines left to complete would be Lionheart. Ringfinger Lionheart. And Yuria's questline. And Yuria's questline is a tricky one to do. It's practically impossible unless you fill out certain requirements. Which I have been doing throughout this entire game. I haven't been making mention of it. Because that's kind of like... What's the word? Yuria's questline basically dictates what ending you get if you do it correctly. So I've been avoiding mentioning it. Because it... spoiler territory. Let's just go in here. Thank you. And we have Aegon. Morn Great Hammer. Morning Shield. I'm sorry, what? What? Alright, fuck me then. Fuck me then, am I right? Jesus. Fucking Jesus. How did he manage to get through there? That shouldn't be a thing. That shouldn't be a thing he can do. God damn it. Anyway. Now that bullshit's sorted. Great Hammer bestowed upon Kareem Knights Great Hammer bestowed upon Kareem Knights with demonstrate. That is wrong. That should be who. Or with demonstrating. But anyway. Demonstrate outstanding strength and unwavering faith. Decorated by a warding charm of Kareem Temple. That should be of the Kareem Temple. And imbued with the twisted rage of Apostle Morn. Morn's Rage. Sick weapon into the earth and emit a powerful shockwave, which also similar to Perseverance, temporarily boosts poise and reduce damage received. Okay, that's a good weapon. I've seen people do mad shit with that. And where's the Morning Shield? Or Moaning Shield, sorry. The Thorn Greatshield given to Aegon of Kareem upon being conferred knighthood. A giant woman's face that protects Aegon is that of his sister, some years his senior. Offer a gentle prayer to the shield, causing the woman's face to give out a low moan and attract enemies. That is some fucked up shit right there. What you got for me, girl? You got some new shit for me. Alright, so we got the Pharum set. Helm named after God of War. Armor of the Ferosa Lion Knights was preserved even after destruction of their homeland and is mentioned in numerous legends alongside the names of those who were said to have gone beyond death. I'm not sure if that refers to what's the name of the kingdom in Dark Souls 2? Dark Souls 1 is Lordran. Dark Souls 2 is Lothric is Dark Souls 3. I don't remember the kingdom's name in Dark Souls 2, but I think it references that. Because I don't remember what the iron description says in Dark Souls 2. But you find the armor hidden underneath the castle of King Vendrick in Dark Souls 2. But I can't for the life of me remember the name of the kingdom. That's going to bother me. Dranglaik, that was it. Dranglaik. And we have the Morn set. Unusual helm bestowed upon Knights of Kareem, modelled on Morn, the Archbishop's Apostle. The helm is a perfect likeness to the stone heads lined the cathedral. A Kareem knight will dedicate an entire career to attending a single maiden, just as Morn once served one goddess alone. So Aegon was dedicated straight up to Arena. Black armor bestowed upon Knights of Kareem, modeled on Morn, Archbishop of Apostles, cast from a unique mineral resembling stone. Green Knights, single maiden, yep. Modeled on Morn. I like the misspelling there, it goes from 1L to 2Ls on modeled. Alright. Gundyr's helm. Ancient helm of a set of cast iron armor belonging to champion Gundyr, modeled after a former king. Gundyr, or the belated champion, was bested by an unknown warrior. He then became a sheath to a coiled sword in the hopes that someday the first flame would be linked once more. Now that says to me, that shit says to me, I went on a little tangent about this and before, but that says to me that we did travel back in time. When we went to the Untended Graves, we went back in time. We fought Gundyr, who was champion Gundyr, who was late to the party. We beat him. And when we beat him, he then stayed for as long as it took for our past self from the start of the game to show up and fight him. It's time travel bullshit. Like back then we beat him. And basically he was tasked with ensuring that no one apart from us would get past. Because if anyone else got past, time would change. They would most likely fail, but since we had bested him, it was clear that we would rise to the occasion, and thus he stayed after we beat him to test us when we returned in the future, which was our past. Like, time travel shit, but I hope you get what I'm saying. Same. Black Hand gear, attire of hunters known as the King's Black Hands. This wide-brimmed hat is emblematic of the role. Black Hand was a title established to honor hunters who served successive kings. To date, no more than 3 such individuals have borne this distinction. And we have seen 2. There's Goddard, and there's the guy with the katanas. I don't know who the third one is. Attire hunters, black cape covers leather armor, shrouded in the wearing darkness. Black hand title savage of honor, to date, 3. Okay. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Got anything new for Miguel? No, nothing new. Alright.
Ashen one.
Thank you. Do you have anything new to say? Before I go back to Lothric Castle, do you have anything new to say?
Hath that so? The eyes show a world, a place. So, I willed myself lord. What is thine? The eyes show a world destitute of a place. But so, what?
No, you have nothing new. All right.
I took them.
You have nothing new. Okay. All right, back to Lothric Castle.